调整后视镜，系好安全带，在教练的指示下安全上路。过去成年后考取汽车驾照，买一台属于自己的车被视为人生重要里程碑，但现在的年轻人却未必这么想。尤其在都会区工作的上班族，首先会选择最方便省时的交通方式。
So there was a time when it took me like almost 3 hours from Gangnam Station to Yeouido, and as you know, going from Seoul to Tokyo also takes 3 hours.
塞车动辄数小时，让开车上班的通勤族感到无奈。市区繁忙的交通不仅影响民众情绪，汽机车排放废气也导致空气污染，许多大都市深受其害。为了改善生活环境，有驾照却选择不开车的人越来越多。
But MZers are known to be quite radically involved in terms of partaking in pressing global issues, mostly involving environmental issues. So either they refrain from purchasing or switch to a hybrid or electric cars.
综合外媒报道，在美国，相较1983年，80%的18岁人口有汽车驾照，2021年只剩下60%。英国16到25岁领有驾照的人数，自2012年算起，8年下跌了10万人。年轻人对开车失去兴趣，不仅显示新时代价值观和生活习惯改变，也反映了青年贫穷问题。
MZers are very smart when it comes to spending matters, and one of the things is we saw in the survey that more than 80% are willing to purchase used cars, meaning that they do understand that car is a depreciating commodity, meaning once you purchase it, the value just keeps dropping.
许多国家的保险费和油价节节上升，导致养车成本逐渐提高，且为了减少因为驾车技术不纯熟导致严重交通事故，各国考照合格标准越来越严格，无法一次通过考试的人可能会因为没办法负担更多驾训课费用而放弃。另外，像是英国大伦敦地区，除了设置超低排放区收取车辆空污费，还自去年开始课征交通拥挤税，上下班尖峰时间进入市区的车都要支付额外费用，让小资年轻人更不可能开车通勤。
People like me are liable to pay the charges, and I simply cannot afford to go to work and back and go to university and really do anything.
有些都会区年轻人则说，由于当今网络发达，社交或生活大小事都能线上处理，减少面对面交流的必要性，自然就不必时常开车出远门。为了健康和环保，他们愿意骑自行车或走路，真的需要使用汽车时，就以租车代替买车，减少负担，也更符合都市生活形态。公视新闻梁彦编译。